topic which I'm going to throw some light, sharing both my personal as well as professional experiences which I've gathered in these last two decades, is change. Now, we all know that change, and you guys very well know that change is something which is constant. Well, it might sound the cliche, but actually it's very, very pertinent to Cairn culture that we are living through. Right from the start, from 98, 99, when Cairn started coming in and operating in this country, till today as I speak, I think all of us, a lot of you out there, have gone through a lot of changes or seen a lot of changes. Now, there are two ways to handle this, you know. The first is, you know, accept changes and get along with it and learn from it. And the second way is, you know, reject it. Just become, you know, saying that change is not for good and that I'm not a part of it, so that's not my cup of tea, and try to move away from it. Well, if you ask me personally, I would choose the first one, because that's what I have been doing myself for the last lot many years which I have been associated with this company. And also beyond that, in my personal life also, I've seen that, you know, accepting change rather than resisting it and figuring out ways to accept it and go above it is the best way to move forward. There are a few reasons for that. First of all, I agree that all changes are not for good, but you can really, if you try to concentrate and figure out that what the change brings in, you will find enough reasons, good reasons, to believe that the change is for good. If you see in our industry, the commodity that we deal with, crude oil, pricing of this crude oil is one of the key factors, right? And we have all seen so many price changes. It's like a sine curve. Can we control the price? I don't think so. And none of us here, or many companies, we can't do that. But figuring out ways to adapt to it and also grow based on that, because a lot of changes brings in a lot of opportunities as well, which we have seen as a company. If you see for the last few years, the low oil price and the high oil price, both has thrown up many, many opportunities at us to grow. For example, I would take specific examples of our chemical UR projects. A lot of you who have worked on these projects, you have seen that they were struggling to operate at very, you know, low oil prices, right? But the moment the price regime changed, a lot of the Shell projects started coming onto reality. And that's what we are seeing now, those seeing the light of the day. On the other hand, when the prices went down, many companies, including us, we became much smarter to do business. And you all know about it. We became much more sleeker. We figured out that what's really needed, what is not needed, and that made us more efficient. So that's one part of it, good thing of a change. The second thing I would like to stress upon here, you as young leaders and learning from this program, is adapting to change. What I have seen from my own experience, I've seen adaptability is one of the biggest quality, you know, one can possess and one can develop. I have learned a lot from my experience in Cairn about being adaptable to changes, because that also gives us a lot of new avenues to grow. Because once I start adapting, once I try to figure out new ways of doing things, I really get chance to work upon the same problem in a different way, and I suddenly see that yes, I'm growing. Both personally I'm growing, as well as the company is growing. So it's a win-win for both the parties. Like, for example, if I now take some global examples of recent past, we all know about the floods which happened in the south of India, very recently in Kerala. How did we come back? That was a big change. But end of the day, people, you know, the human resources, the people who accepted that change, they became resilient to that, and they started figuring out new ways to adapt and to survive, has actually made us again back to normal. If you compare Japan, after all the earthquakes, the tsunamis, how did they bounce back? They face changes every day. and those are natural calamity changes, but they bounce back every time that challenge is thrown at them. How do they do that? The only way they do that is because they are very adaptable to accept changes, be it natural calamities or in the man-made changes. So to summarize, end of the day, one thing is very constant, that is change. And we all know that. We see that in our personal lives, we see that in our professional lives. So does it stop us? Absolutely not. We need to make use of that change and turn it into opportunities. So first and foremost, team, we need to be resilient about change. We need to be adaptive about changes. And we need to figure out and look for opportunities in the change environment. Because if you see our track record for the last two decades, we have been exposed to a lot of changes, especially a lot of organization design. But has it impacted our delivery? By no means. We have grown and we have delivered much better than before with the new changed organization. So I'd like to assure you that accepting change and developing the new ideas which comes along with the change and becoming resilient to change and adapting to the changed environment, all is a successful formula to deliver our goals, both the personal goals, the personal KPIs, as well as the professional goals, and as well as the vision of the company. So all the very best to all of you in this program. I'm sure this program is going to offer you multiple tricks of the trade in handling changes, handling new environments, handling different professional changed environments, organization design, and you will be a much, much more better person to handle changes after this course. So make use of it, because a lot of us and many other senior leaders have seen this program, we have given our thoughts into it, so it's very well stitched together specifically for you guys.